Hello everyone, I'm Cheng Wen-tsan, Taoyuan City Mayor from Taiwan. This September, I was invited to attend the Budapest Forum, where I signed the Pact of Free Cities with 20 other cities around the globe to declare Taoyuan determination to uphold democracy and freedom. I'm happy to be here again to speak about Taiwan under the threat of China. After the Russia-Ukraine war broke out, I attended the Together for Ukraine online meeting held by the Pact of Free Cities, together with other cities across the world, to voice our support for Ukraine on March 4th. In Taoyuan, we projected colors of blue and yellow that stand for the flag of Ukraine to the city hall. People in Taiwan also made in kind and cash donations to show our support for Ukraine. We can relate to Ukraine because we are right next to China, a hegemony that seeks to suppress us in every way possible. In addition, China has never renounced the use of force to bring Taiwan under its control since Xi Jinping took the reign of the CCP. China has abandoned its hide and buy policy and initiated a series of aggressive actions, including its heightened political intimidation and military coercion against Taiwan. In recent years, through its diplomatic coercion and inducements, Beijing has forced as many as 8 diplomatic allies of Taiwan to cut ties with Taiwan in an attempt to isolate us. China's suppression of Taiwan's participation in international organizations never stopped. At the worst of the COVID-19 pandemic, China also prevented our delegation from attending the WHA, putting politics above public health and disregarding human welfare. Taiwan faced millions of cyber attacks and massive misinformation and disinformation campaigns. Are organized to shake our political and economic stability. The PLA's frequent military drills in waters around Taiwan and the fighter jets and the warships sent across the median line of the Taiwan Strait also pose threat to regional security and heighten the risk of military misjudgment. Despite China's brutal actions, Taiwan still strives to cultivate its diplomatic relationship with other countries. Our engagement with like-minded partners such as the US, Japan, and the European countries uphold the spirit of professionalism and pragmatism. We will play our role as a member of the international community to maintain peace and prosperity in the Indo-Pacific region. The U.S. has maintained a close relationship with Taiwan based on the Taiwan Relations Act. Taiwan and the U.S. enjoy frequent political and economic exchanges, as well as robust official and civilian interactions with each other. In the face of the growing threat from China, the U.S. Congress has passed many bills friendly toward Taiwan, such as the Taiwan Travel Act, the Asia Reassurance Initiative Act, and the Taipei Act to deepen Taiwan-U.S. relations. A while ago, the U.S. Senate Foreign Relations Committee passed the Taiwan Policy Act of 2022 in hopes of strengthening Taiwan's security by substantially enhancing our bilateral military and economic cooperation. Military-wise, the U.S. continues to provide Taiwan with advanced defensive weapons to increase Taiwan's defensive asymmetrical capabilities in countering China military threats. On August 2nd, U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi led a congressional delegation to visit Taiwan, demonstrating their support for Taiwan through action. This was the first visit of a current House Speaker to Taiwan since the former Speaker Gingrich visited 25 years ago. From Taiwan-friendly bills to the Speaker's visit, the U.S. Congress has demonstrated strong support for Taiwan and the determination to secure democracy. The CPTPP, chaired by Japan this year, is a regional organization that Taiwan seeks to join. On September 22nd this year, Taiwan submitted its application to the CPTPP. This marks a huge step for Taiwan's participation in regional economic integration, as Taiwan's trade volume with CPTPP member accounts for 24% of the country's total. However, 6 days prior to Taiwan's submission, the PRC submitted its application and objected to Taiwan's accession on the ground of one China, shutting the door to Taiwan's entry. As most CPTPP member states avoided getting involved in the complicated competition between Taiwan and the PRC, Japan still voiced its support for Taiwan's entry into CPTPP. When the Japanese Delta delegation visited Taiwan, they also voiced their support for Taiwan to join more international organizations such as the CPTPP, WHO, and the ICAO. Both Japan and Taiwan agreed that Taiwan's entry will be reciprocally beneficial to each other, as stated by the late former Prime Minister Shinzong Abe. If something happens to Taiwan, it means something happens to Japan, which is the same as the something happened to the Japan-US alliance. What Prime Minister Abe said implies the inclusion of Taiwan in the Pacific Rim economic framework and the Japan-US alliance. As the Chinese hegemony began to rise, the tension across the Taiwan Strait escalated. The Quad initiative by Japan has become a major mechanism to mitigate and to balance China's rise. The Quad upholds the spirit of freedom, openness, tolerance, and democracy, which all speak to Taiwan's belief. As Taiwan and Japan both safeguard the universal value of democracy, freedom, and human rights, the two countries should work hand in hand to prevent authoritarian countries from invading to these values. We maintain proactive in our engagement with Japan to raise Taiwan's awareness of self-defense. With the support of Japan, we hope to build a deeper cooperative relationship along the first island chain in the Western Pacific and jointly defend ourselves against the threats from China. In Europe, parliaments have passed bills in support of Taiwan, and the members of parliaments across parties and countries have visited Taiwan in a chain of delegation to show their support for Taiwan in real action. For example, following the visit of a delegation of the European Parliament led by French MEP Raphael Glucksmann to Taipei last year, a delegation led by Vice President of the European Parliament Nicolas Beer also visited Taiwan this year, demonstrating the strong support of the European Parliament to Taiwan. Vice President Beer has long been a strong supporter of Taiwan's freedom and democracy. Not only did she back the resolutions regarding Taiwan and sign the petition for Taiwan's participation in the WHA and other international organizations, but she also expressed her concern for the security across the Taiwan Strait through written and oral interpellations. As a very important friend of Taiwan, Vice President Beer has openly urged the EU and its member states to take concrete actions to elevate the EU's relations with Taiwan. In February, the European Parliament adopted the resolutions of common foreign and security policy and common security and defense policy, in which they strongly condemn Russia's invasion of Ukraine, as well as China's coercion against Lithuania and other EU member states, and its suppression of Hong Kong's democracy and freedom. Meanwhile, the European Parliament also urged the EU to forge closer partnerships and bilateral investment treaties with Taiwan. Following China's military exercise around Taiwan, after Speaker Nancy Pelosi's visit, the five major political groups of the European Parliament put forward a joint motion for a resolution on the situation in the Strait of Taiwan. The resolution demands the EU help ensure security in the Taiwan Strait, calls for European countries to set up representative offices in Taiwan, and urges the EU to send future official parliamentary delegation to Taiwan. This is the eighth document in support of Taiwan adopted by the European Parliament. It demonstrates the high concerns from MEPs across different countries and political groups for peace and stability in the Taiwan Strait. Lastly, I would like to take this opportunity to extend my gratitude to Mayor Carocioni and the organizer for hosting such a meaningful event that gathers the strength of democracy. I hope that the participants of the event can continue to pay attention to the situation across the Taiwan Strait together, condemn China's hegemonic acts together, safeguard Taiwan's status as Asia's beacon of democracy together, and help ensure peace and stability in this region. With your help, we can ensure that the beacon of democracy will continue to shine over the Western Pacific and light up the darkness. Thank you.